Okay, so as usual here, we're just starting out with priming the upper hull with primer. And then I've taped off an area here where I'm going to try something a little different this time. I'm going to spray these areas with a medium gray, and then I'm going to spray some other areas here with red brown, and I'm doing this before I spray the body color over it to slightly tint the body color to make some of the panels just a touch different. And then I'm going through with all, like all the others, I'm doing the pre-shading with black between the panel lines and then the body color. It's a little hard to tell, but there is a little tint difference between the panels. And now I'm going to put in the three recesses in the upper hull. So there is one other mod that I did, and this was actually almost 2 years ago when I started. The upper well turret here. For one, the window is not aligned properly. So I cut it out, rotated it the right direction, and then glued it back into position the way it should be. Another mod I did is I wanted it to look more like the 5-foot model with a little more detail. So I primed it. I cut out some little square styrene strips and stuck them around in the proper positions, and added just a touch more detail, as you can see in this photo, which is more accurate to the 5-foot filming miniature. And then primed again. Here's a before and after shot. You can see how I just have more of the little panel bumps. Then it was time to put all the little greeblies all around the upper hull, now that I have it painted with the body color. And then we have all these bags of greeblies, which are all to be put on the rear engine part of the hull. There's over 120 greeblies to attach to the rear. So at this point, it's time to remove this panel from the upper hull that you see here in my hand. And then it will be attached to the cockpit tube, which was finished up in the previous video. And those will be secured together by some screws. And then the whole tube assembly will carefully avoid pinching the fiber optics. Will carefully be screwed and reattached to the upper hull. Then I used my little self-adhesive wire tie-downs to secure the power wires for the LEDs in the cockpit tube, and also to secure down the fiber optics themselves. And like in the cockpit, I put some little styrene tubing over the ends to keep them together to slip into the LED. Now that the tube is attached to the upper hull, it's time to put the little greeblies along the top. So then it's a little bit of black wash over all the little items along the top of the tube. Used a little bit of rust for weathering to add just a touch of color to it rather than just gray and black. Then airbrushing some of the blast marks seen around the cockpit tube. And here we have the upper hull with gray weathering. Then I decided to go through and add just a touch of color using red-brown. And then also added some darker areas with just straight flat black. So here I've installed my photo etched gunner port into the upper hull, and I'm going to glue in the little stairwell which goes between the upper and lower gun turrets. And then I also cut some styrene out and filled in these holes where you could see light coming through when the top is exposed to show the inside cargo hold. And you can see here where I filled it in, I painted them black so that no light would leak through. Then it's pulling the sides off the lower section of the Millennium Falcon, and it's time to take the upper hull and carefully lower it onto the bottom hull, making sure that the stairwell goes through the lower tube and everything lines up properly. Securing the upper hull to the lower hull with screws all around. Reattaching all my magnetized side panels. Plugging in the wires from the upper hull into the circuit board. And a quick test of the lighting. Cockpit lights up. All of my caution lights are lighting up properly. The ramp is working okay. And the lights are lighting up inside the cargo hold. So then it's securing the rear engine section to the upper hull. So I did a concept in Photoshop of a table that I would like to do to display my Millennium Falcon. And these are a couple of pictures of what I had planned with a glowing lighted edge around the table and some buttons on the edge that would turn on and off the Falcon and the lights around the table and so on. So I went out to IKEA and I bought this kitchen table here. And then I went ahead and assembled it. And I cut the legs down to shorten them up a little bit because I didn't want it kitchen table height. And I bought this extra table top and I notched it on the corners. And then I secured it to the underside of the kitchen table to make a shelf where I could put the instruction manuals for the model as well as some of my books. I also bought this in-dash LCD display, a media player, and a speaker, and this LED tape, which will go around the table to light it. So I began by drilling out a hole and cutting it out to put the in-dash LCD display into the side of the table. And then I secured it to the table, and then I mounted with just Velcro, because it's so light, the media player to the underside next to my LCD display. And then mounted the speaker in the upper right corner there that you can see, ran my power cables and such. And I also bought all these lighted switches, and I got red, green, yellow, blue, and I drilled holes on either side of my LCD display. I drilled three on each side. Cut them out so that I can put the switches inside of them, and I'm using red, green, and blue, and these switches will control the table itself, the Millennium Falcon, turn on and off the speaker, the LCD display, and everything. So I got this gloss black sheet of plexiglass, which will be the top of the table, and I got this board here, which I cut about 4 inches shorter in all dimensions than the plexiglass, and then I centered it in the middle of the plexiglass. Got my LED light strip, and then I ran that around the edge of the board, securing it to the plexiglass, as you can see here. And then a little test lighting, and you can see that it lights up. So then I drilled some holes into my table so that I could then screw in from the bottom into the plexiglass top, and it's secured to my tabletop. Then I got a surveillance camera mount, drilled a hole for my power cord to come through, secured that to the table, and this is where the Millennium Falcon will mount and stand on my table.